Well, it's pretty early in the evening and a lot of fans late showing up thinking the best skaters might skate last, but it's a random draw in the short program, and they've missed Plushenko, putting up the highest total ever in a short program. Up next, Jeffrey Buttle of Canada, silver medalist at the World Championships last year. His first Olympics.
Jeffrey's strength is in the component marks, the program marks. His choreography was just adored by this panel of judges. The short program is completely within his ability to pull off. He opens with a triple flip, triple toe loop combination, triple flip, triple toe loop. Nicely done. Triple axel next. Again, forward takeoff, 3.5 revolutions. Short, a little bit short on the landing. If he didn't make it to a quarter turn, he'll get only credit for a double axel, and that will completely affect his score beyond the fall.
A mandatory point deduction for the fall, but he will still get some points in the new system.
What he is a dancer. You can see that in every step he takes. That's a nice quality and all too often lost in the professional skating, the amateur skating competitive world.
What's exciting about the men's event is that choreography does matter. The standard, the technical standard, is so high that they do have to pay attention to choreography and style, edge quality. He's got that.
Triple lats, a hand down.
You know, he's skated 4 competitions before this, 4 times clean. The pressure of the Olympics is like nothing else.
He's been a little up and down in practice while he's been here. He's had some great practices and some really rough practices. He's looked a little distracted. Any mistakes in these short programs just gives points to the rest of the field.
Yep.
Showing a little sense of humor at the end of that program. You're not allowed to touch the wall, and he was right in front of the judges. He goes, "I'm not gonna touch." Nope, I'm not.
You know, when he was about 6 years old, his mom videotaped his first competition, and he stopped right in the middle of it, looked up in the stands, and waved to her. And by the way, his mom was here tonight to see him skate in the Olympics.
Falling the triple axel. Now let's watch the landing especially. He gets up in the air pretty good. He looks pretty good here. Now watch the landing there. They're going to review that landing to see if he got all the way around backwards. If he didn't, it changes the value of the jump to a double. Great spin at the end there. But the fall will cost him at least 4 points.
The judges can call it up on videotape on their computer consoles in front of them to see just what took place. There's a look at the console that each judge has. And by the way, the technical specialist is the man that calls out each element. Then it's up to the judges to judge it. Look who the technical specialist is tonight. You recognize him? Viktor Petrenko, 92 gold medalist for the unified team of all the former Soviet republics. And Tracy Wilson has one of those consoles, and she took a look at Plushenko's quad-triple combination. Tracy?
Tom, Plyshenko has been able to dominate men's skating because he has the quad and it is so consistent. Here's why that matters in the short program. There are, of course, 8 required elements, and only 3 of those elements can be jumps. One has to be a double or a triple axel. Another triple comes out of footwork. So the men are doing their quad in combination. Huge marks if you land your quad triple. That's 13 points. Evgeny Plyshenko does his combination so well, he picks up extra marks for the grade of execution. Today, he took home almost 14 points. For those skaters who turn the quad and fall, they miss the second triple and drop all the way down to 5 points. So that's why you'll see a lot of skaters opting out of the quad, doing a triple-triple combination. For Evgeny Plyshenko, it's an opportunity for him to distance himself from the field.
The technical score, please.
And a disappointed Jeffrey Buttle awaits his marks.
His technical score is 37.01
37.28. There's that point deduction for the fall. 73.29 puts him momentarily, at least, into third place. And you see the disappointment in his first Olympic skate. Now, Plyshenko, though.